Greenheck, building value in air.
Hi, I'm Mark Schultz, application engineer with Greenheck. Today, we're going to go over startup on our Vektor System Control. I'll show you some tips on maximizing your performance and troubleshooting. I've set up a two-fan system here, so we've got two VFDs. We've already verified our wiring. Our duct is open and ready for service. So when I'm ready here, I'm going to fire up these VFDs. With a two-fan system, I'm going to have to do one extra step. I do have to address VFD number two from 1 to 2. This is a very simple step I'll show you right now. Just go into your quick menu, hit OK at my personal menu, scroll to 8-31. That's gonna be your addressing, hit OK. And we're gonna change this from 1 to 2, hit OK. Then we can just hit the status to take us back to our menu. Now we're gonna move over to the control box. I'm gonna apply power, bring up our PLC, and I'll show you how to adjust your static pressure. The factory default on your static pressure is always going to be 1 inch, so we're going to need to adjust that to whatever your system requirements are. From our main menu, we can go ahead and hit the program key. I want to log into the unit, so just arrow down. When I log in, it is going to ask me for a password. Password's going to be 9998. This will be our service level password. Now we'll just arrow down to test and balance. And this is where we're gonna make our static pressure adjustment. You'll notice my static pressure right now set. I'm gonna change it to 2 inches. So go ahead and hit enter. I'm gonna hit enter. My static pressure is set. One of the things we can also do when you're doing test and balance is you can determine where your steady state for your fan run is gonna be. This will help us go back in later to maximize your performance. Once you've determined where your lowest requirement is and your highest requirement is, we can go ahead and go into test and balance again, arrow down, and you're gonna see a fan start, a min fan percent, and a max fan percentage. We can now get our fan start should be set wherever your steady state run is gonna be. Your minimum should be set 10% below your lowest requirement, and your maximum should be set 10% above your highest requirement for running. Now remember, these are percentages, not hertz. Occasionally we'll get some calls on system alarms. One of the more frequent ones is going to be when the VFD gets set in hand mode instead of auto mode. What'll happen is your PLC will alarm out. I can go ahead and hit the alarm on there. It'll tell me VFD2 not in auto mode. So this is a real easy one to clear. We come back to the VFD, just needs to be put back into auto mode. That should clear that one. If the VFD gets set off, or for some reason the disconnect gets turned off on the VFD, again, you're seeing my alarm here. It's telling me the VFD, not in auto mode, so I can go ahead and clear that alarm. Just by resetting into auto mode. Another common alarm we get is when power is disconnected from the pressure transducer or static is not being registered by the pressure transducer. That alarm would also show up on here on my PLC. When that alarm comes up, it won't be able to clear itself. I'm gonna have to go in and clear that alarm. Once I've restored power, I can then go in and clear this alarm. So right now, my alarm is telling me I have a pressure probe alarm. I'm gonna go ahead and fix that. I can see here, I do not have a reading. So I'm gonna take off the faceplate. I'm gonna check my connection here. I'm gonna check my connection here. That was loose. I'm now seeing the illumination I wanna see. Put the cover back on. You can always refer to your wiring diagrams to verify all these. Check your static pressure probe, but this should clear that alarm. Now that I've reconnected my pressure transducer, I have to go in and clear this alarm. All you need to do is arrow down in your alarm screen. Hold this for 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. That should clear our alarm. No alarms. I'm back in business. The Vektor System Control is also BACnet compatible. There's other system overrides and alarms that can be tied in. All those details can be found in your IOM. You can always contact your Greenheck representative for more information or go to greenheck.com. As always, make it a great day with Greenheck.